When Isabella was 4 years old, she got into an accident. She got hit by a car in a driveway, and she was non-responsive when the paramedics got there. They rushed her to the hospital, and I believe it was 12 operations she had within the first couple days.
Although they tried to fix her in the right place, it's very difficult when you get injured as a child because it usually injures the growth centers. And so then as they grow, the side that's injured may not grow as normally as the other side.
The trauma doc that we saw, his first words to me were, if she makes it, she'll be here at least 30 days. And walked out the very next Friday. From that day, we knew how tough she was.
So as she grew, the left side of her eyes, or the orbit is the bony box that contains the eye. This did not grow as much as this side. In addition, she had the bones of her forehead, including the rim above your eye, and the denting of the forehead. Those also got worse with time. If that went on long enough, her eyes would be such a different height that she could have double vision because you're literally seeing at two different levels. It's difficult with the camera to capture the shadowing and the dent and how obvious that is and how it bothers her. Every time she combs her hair, brushes her hair, she can feel that dent, that reminder of being in a car accident. There are ways to mask things like this with fat grafting, which is another plastic surgery technique, but that will never correct the corner of the eyes. That requires a larger craniofacial operation. The parents and Isabella felt that this is what she really wanted, to feel normal again, and so we decided to go ahead with the surgery around then.
I think it was close to 12 hours for the entire surgery, and she did a really good job. They kept us posted the whole time.
3D printed representation of our goal and the final of this patient, and the green shows the orbit cut around and moved up, and the pink here shows the bone graft that is put under in order to lift the orbit and keep it up there. This blue are the titanium plates and screws. Once we move things up, this disrupts the nose, so I have to put in another purple bone graft to make the nose have a normal nasal shape, otherwise it would be sunken in like a saddle. She was also flat here, so we took a bone graft and put bone here, otherwise this would be round and this would be sunken in. And you can see on this view with that purple bone graft, it looks symmetric. And then finally her dent here, I couldn't make the dent come out because the bone was too thin. So I took the entire forehead and turned it 180 degrees. And you can see this represents the dent, the orange. That orange used to be right here. But after surgery, we turned it 180, and now the forehead is normalized.